Can I give you a word of advice, Wayu?
By all means.
You're welcome to play your little we're all friends here game with me, but I wouldn't try it with Captain Sisko. He's not in the mood.
We're on a mission of peace, Major. Maybe he should get in the mood. This is the border as it existed before hostilities broke out. This is the border we are now proposing.
This arrangement would award disputed star systems to the side that already has effective control over them. On the balance, we are giving up more than you.
Computer, freeze program. Computer. Hi, listen. Go to native language mode and replay time code 761 through 769.
Ijana Manohova, Bali Jenkorada, Sento.
Got you. Did you hear that? Use the passive voice transitive.
Says when could you speak Dominionese?
Since this morning. That phrasing is only used to make a request, not a statement. They are up to something.
What is it, Patrick? Did you see something?
You can tell us.
They want the Cabral system.
How do you know?
They kept avoiding it with their eyes.
Are you sure?
They kept avoiding it.
Told you they were up to something.
End program. All right, they want the Cabral system, but why?
I don't know, but they're willing to give up a lot to get it. The Mizanite deposits on Holnafor alone are enough to keep their shipyards running for years.
Yes. That's typical Dominion strategy. They offer to give up something valuable in order to hide the fact that they want something even more valuable in the long term. See, that's how they think. Big picture. They don't worry about what's going to happen tomorrow. No. They're thinking long term. They're thinking what's going to happen a year from now, a decade, a century. Yes.
There must be something special about the Cabral system.
Nothing on the first planet but some simple protozoids and trinucleic fungi. The second planet has some cormaline deposits, but they're common enough.
Okay. Maybe there's another reason. Does it have any strategic value?
Not that I can see. They wouldn't want to build a base there.
Why not? Seems perfectly suitable.
It's not an optimum situation. It's a binary system. There's a lot of bionic interference there.
All right. Forget.
Does this have anything to do with what we're talking about, Serena? Can we take it?
Like an ancient technology.
There's no evidence of anything like that.
Any idea what this might mean?
Chemistry was never my strong suit. What is it?
It shows how you can break down trinucleic fungus to make iridium bicantazine, one of the active ingredients in Ketracel White. That's why the Dominion wants the Cabral system, so that they can manufacture the drug right here in the Alpha Quadrant. According to our calculations, they'll be able to manufacture enough to supply the Jem'Hadar indefinitely.
I was going to recommend that the Federation accept the proposed border. It could have cost us the Alpha Quadrant.
Actually, sir, we should give them Cabral.
Why is that?
If we don't, the Dominion will be forced to attack before their stockpile of white runs out. Here are the casualty projections, as you can see. An attack would result in devastating casualties for both sides.
You're suggesting we stall?
It'll buy us time to rebuild our defenses and bring the Romulans into the Alliance.
The Romulans?
According to our analyses... There it is. They'll vote to abandon their non-aggression pact with the Dominion at next year's plenary session, by which time internal pressures between the Cardassians and the Dominion will have erupted. And after 3 years, 6 months and 27 days, we predict that...
Hang on a minute, Doctor. How'd you come up with all this? 2 days ago, you said these people were impossible to deal with. Now they're turning out projections that it would take Starfleet intelligence months to come up with.
We're mutants. I know, we're not exactly qualified for this kind of work, and it could be said that it is beyond the limits of what people like us should be allowed to do. But I think if you allow me to walk you through our analyses, you'll be impressed.
All right, Doctor, go ahead.
Thank you, sir. The way our statistical analysis works, the further into the future you go, the more accurate the projection. It's based on a kind of non-linear dynamics, whereby small fluctuations tend to factor out over time. The net result...
Just a minute, Doctor. Why don't we go back to the beginning and take me through this step by step? Nice and easy.
Gladly, sir. Captain Sisko said he would take our analysis to Starfleet Command right away.